Yeah, what's happening? What it do? Welcome to it. It's the biggest, the dopest, the freshest, the sickest, the illest entertainment show on your TV screens, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Beat Down with your boy, Mangaliso Masilela, aka L4, aka L-Fizzle. And this is the top 10 hottest music videos from all over the world. Wherever the turn up is, we take it, we box it, put it in a box, put it in a plane, fly it down, sanitize it, and then distribute right here on from Eswatini TV. Every Saturday at 8 p.m. Without further more ado, we'll kick off the show. Got the videos, some dope interviews for you guys. So sit back, you're gonna love it. It's your boy, it's your show. Let's get it on the road.
Dallas Porsche, so we're like, boom, boom. Feliz the words on the come up.
One day I know but it's all set out cash. Manga bebo kona mangtala kutul. Stop in zesbona ni langa malpum. All of those tears umtalu tatsul. Bati I waste wana ngakful. Nao makama genyo wakumpul. Eish I pray you lale ngakutul. Nao eba naga njeno munga seko. Pa stop in zesbona ni ngale wel tu.
Stomu yesbona ni. Stomu yesbona ni. Stomu yesbona ni.
Somewhere's born,
TBD Babe, we're still out here on the beat down with your boy. And Ware, wow. A lot has been happening online, on Twitter. I've said it before, I'll say it again. If you stay on Twitter, every day something's trending for someone's trending for some. I'm just thinking to myself right now, there's so much to talk about, so much happening. You know, different views, different things being said about that and that. Some things I'll just leave and wait till, you know, verdicts come out. Like, for instance, everybody knows, I told you guys when it happened weeks ago, obviously the sad passing of Anele. Now there's so much coming out, you know, suspicions of what could have caused or what could have influenced the final, of course, sad occurrence of her passing away. You know, lots of news coming out about what life was like when she was still alive. You know, so it's a whole lot of things happening with that. Then there's the other feud between Nota, which is Questa's former manager, and Makwa, which is Nota's, should I say, former producer or still producer, and some guy called Leroy, who was a business partner. People are talking about money being chowed. Lo nukomba lo, lo nukomba lo. It's like, who chowed the money? Because Makwa was saying that he never got paid royalties for some of the songs. You know, and he was blaming Nota. Nota's blaming Leroy and Questa. Questa's saying, hey, I don't know who to blame. I don't know. It really got me asking myself, Questa, do you really not know? Anyway, as that unfolds as well, I'll continue telling you what's up and what's going on with that. But the biggest one is the 500K one. For those of you who don't know, there's a young boy called Ria Bone. I think that's how you pronounce it, Ria. He has a podcast because we're living in the podcast world now, the era, actually. A whole lot of podcasts are popping. You got Mac G doing the biggest numbers. You've got a whole lot of people, Popcast, Bible School, a lot of podcasts that are, you know, just doing their thing. And it's great. I can't wait for it to hit Eswatini. So we also love that. But anyway, I digress. This boy went on his, I say boy, he's only 22. He went on his podcast and he was with his friend and they suddenly said some things, and unfortunately didn't use the word allegedly, that they spoke as if they were speaking in fact. They said that AKA was on drugs and Wonang Ateba taught them the drugs. And I remember watching this video and his friend was like, yo, we ain't got no facts, man, stop it, because he wasn't trying to catch that heat. But this boy was like, nah, it's known, man. It's known.
It's known.
But you know, Rhea, let me say this to you. Let me say this to you, ne? Let me say this to you.
Let's not run away from the truth.
Let me say this. Let me say this to you. Such accusations, especially with no...
What? Which accusation? Who am I accusing of what?
He's saying he's on drugs.
That's not what I'm saying.
He said he's on coke.
Scoop told us.
Known. And that kind of trended. People are like, yo, this boy, how can you say such things like that? Or whatever. And then Monang came back and said she wants his email, she's trying to get a hold of him, he's not picking up when she calls. Next thing we know, boom, lawsuit. Monang is suing the boy for 500k, and she also wanted a retraction and an apology. That trended, obviously. Everyone went wild as to what the heck is going to happen now. Now here's the wild thing. With all that happening, the boy comes back, he apologizes, obviously, because ain't nobody trying to pay no 500k. And Bonanga's like, cool, now where's my money? Now for my money. And then now, afterwards, the boy's making certain jokes, like it ain't serious, you know, like he ain't scared or none, like, hi, man. Because some people are feeling sympathy towards him, like, I say it's just a boy, Bonang, you're here, you're multi... people know you in multiple countries, you have this big brand, come on, let the boy live or whatever. But now it's starting to look like the boy wanted this, you know, like, I think it looks like he wanted this sort of type of publicity, talking about how to catch the podcast, we'll discuss all of this, I'll tell all interview, whatnot, because he also implicated people like Boscoop. So we're still to hear from what still to hear what Scoop's gonna say about stuff like this. But hey, you know, it's just wild. That's the internet for you. 1 minute we're tweeting, next minute we're receiving lawsuits. It's just wild. Anyway, I'll keep you guys in the loop on what's happening with all of that. Keep your eyes on the screen every Saturday at 8, okay? For now, let's check out this jam. I'll be back.
Jelly bar, no ice skating. I did that on thin ice. On the edge, slippers lie like a nigga may live twice. So she's saying I'm sweet. I tell a bitch I've been nice. Set my future bright. Hit it from behind in dim lights. Got me thinking, if it ain't working, why try? My life is a movie. I'm in the space of living sci-fi. Couple blunts got me skipping steps. They got like how high. Had to cut the strings, but didn't mean to live a tongue tie. Thanking God I got a roof on my head. Remember when I spent a year without a blanket or bed. So if you're skipping on me, I guess it might be your bed. I never close my eyes, I'll cover my ears instead. Headphones on, empty, blasting my eardrums. These habits always chasing me, I'm living life on the run. Dang, always hoping I see the sun. Cause if I kick the bucket, old lady, you can see the sun. Like I don't know what she would think of me. We should still see the little boy that she had always seen. Every time that little one is sick, she taking care of me. And now I'm always gonna be from the scared of me, I'm sick of me. But I got a new birdie, she always so fly. Turn into an angel on my couch when we both high. Gotta put the hickeys on your neck like a bow tie. Mind is singing blues, you already got a cold side. Chasing money, got me breaking the law. Got me going through the most and now my feelings are sore. Fuck the grudge, I hold a knife to your throat. Now the streets are getting cold, picks up heat and you're cold. Oh,
right now we are I'm a man. Kulume manga kakul. Ay, you might be failing like Eve. Know exactly what God say. Never do that, do this. This is more like a test. Ay, tata tamba la kulbega kuya ngoba nguya no what is bad. Oh my God, now we're out. He's more than goodly.
I'm an uptown boy with the uptown god. Uang yang kena batang egen kene. Uang yang puma and I have no scars. Ah, yeah, God so bitter. God my healer, my redeemer. Egen yang pila. Wako kota nga pula wang gena nga pila nga ngaba. Hey, now.
TVD baby, we're still out here. You know what it is? It's the dopest. This is, of course, the beatdown with your boy Alfizzle. Now, 1963, on the 25th of May, 32 countries were there, you know, to Sainda and put us Lala for an organization called the Organization of African Unity. And from that day till today, on the 25th of May, we celebrate Africa Day. And you are African, wherever you are watching from here. I'd like to believe no one is streaming from America or anything that's illegal, just so you know. Anyway, Africa Day is coming up next week, and FNB wants to, you know, make it really fun this year for everybody, particularly with what COVID is bringing. They're saying, no, we'll fight against COVID and we will make sure you are entertained and you are happy. And we're going to give them an opportunity to tell us all about what they have in store for us. So I have with me right now Ndobeko Dlamini, who is the communications manager at FNB Eswatini, and she's going to tell us what's happening on Tuesday. Hi, Dobbs.
Hi, Alpha. How are you?
I'm fantastic. How are you doing?
Good, good, good. Thank you so much for having us.
Thanks for coming through.
Yeah, so FNB is hosting a Pan-African concert called the FNB Africa Day Concert. And we're just looking, we're using this as an opportunity to not only celebrate diversity, unity, but we've also put together a collection of talented African artists coming from Lesotho, Ghana, Botswana, Namibia, and of course Eswatini. Oh. Yeah, of course Eswatini. FNB Eswatini has always been loyal to the arts.
True.
You guys know that through our Smoothfest events and a variety of other events. And we saw this as an opportunity to bring forth our own local talent, our own local artists, and ensure that they're able to perform on a continental virtual stage, which is the FNB Africa Day concert. And yeah, this concert is basically an opportunity for us to create a concert that imagines the virtual stage. And we'll be doing that through our concert. It'll be a mix of sound, of music, of poetry, and of a collection of artists from diverse backgrounds, diverse genres, all coming together to remind us all about what it means to be truly African. So yeah, the bank also wanted to utilize the digital space. As we all know, we've sort of had to adapt to the new normal, and we are using this digital space to bring together thousands of viewers to enjoy that African experience through this concert. So we're encouraging customers, the public at large, to make sure that they watch our concert on Tuesday, the 25th of May, We'll be streaming the concert on the FNB Namibia Facebook page, their YouTube page, as well as One Africa TV from 4 o'clock. So join us as we celebrate being African.
I think I want to allow you a chance to maybe echo what you were saying, because a lot of the time when a company does great things in terms of promoting something good for the people, a lot of people sit back and think maybe this is just for the bank. Mm-hmm. But I think what I pick up from it, especially with the fact that you guys do things like the Smooth Fest, obviously being stopped by COVID now, mm-hmm. where we get to see some of our own artists, you know, going toe-to-toe on the same stage with some big artists. And now, again, you're saying with this concert coming up, we're also going to have our own. We've got Fans and Vele Mseni. So I think a lot of people forget now to also play their part in terms of understanding the message that's being pushed here, mm-hmm. to support local, to be proud of being African, you know, and understanding that Africa Day is not just, you know, corporations sitting there and doing what they can, but people must also be part of the message.
100%. And I think for us, as you've mentioned, we have Sands and Vele Mseni. Those are Smooth Fest alumni. And as well as Kulegani, our artist who will be performing. We as the bank understand that we need to celebrate our people. And celebrating being African is also celebrating being Luswati. And that is why, you know, we reached out to these artists that we've collaborated with in the past to say, how can we make sure that their voices, their art, their work is amplified on such a large stage.
Shout out to that. Just a reminder, because a lot of people might be sitting there thinking, I beg Mali, nigga. This is free.
Completely free. All you need to do is just access the Facebook pages, the YouTube page, and One Africa TV. But log on to FNB Namibia's Facebook page, their YouTube page, and there's no cost. It's just data and Wi-Fi. But yeah, it's a completely free concert.
Shout out to FNB. You guys are really pushing the innovation, huh? You really want to talk to the young people. You want to talk to all the people, but you want to move in with the future, huh? The awards speak for themselves. I mean, the awards coming through also speaks volumes to that.
100%, Alpha. I think FNB has won the most valuable banking brand 2 years in a row. And that just speaks to the work that we do as a brand, and showcasing that people actually value the work we do and the products that we offer to our customers. I mean, we always speak about the fact that our tagline is, how can we help you? So help is in our DNA as a brand, and we're always looking at innovative ways that we can make banking simpler, more secure, and better for our customers.
Thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you so much, Alpha, for having me. Thank you.
It's really nice to hear such nice things. 4 p.m. on Tuesday, so make sure it's on the FNB Namibia
page, their YouTube page as well as One Africa TV.
There we go. Don't miss it Tuesday. It's going to be live for you for free, mahala. So you ain't got to pay nothing. You know, shout out to FNB for that. We're going to have Sands later on, who's going to talk to us about what this means to him. For now, let's check out this gem.
La la, na 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 na. Yeah. Why you wanna do me like that? I love the way you move it like that. When you move your body, it's like you know. Got me going cuckoo like that. Yeah. I was thinking you and your friends. Sing a song and listen to me. Summer vibes, can turn choking up on blood. In summer vibes, yeah. In summer love, yeah, I'm covering somebody tonight. Yeah, in summer love.
Shout to you the shit and you know it. Shout to you the rip and I'm so it. Fly a real nigga, you know it. I ain't talking no bluffs, I'ma show it. Shawty say she wanna learn about foreplay. Okay, little baby, let me tell you what your role is. Body like that, got a nigga straight zoning. I like to hit it sideways, shawty in the morning. Hey, now you never wish anymore. Gene gas la moya moya, let's go. You ain't gotta worry, my babies, that they know me. Set there with a couple of drinks of alcohol. Yeah, get full in tour. Forget about the past, now you gotta move forward. X wasn't lame, cause you know we can't afford this. Let me put you on game, yeah, we swore.
Why you wanna do me like that? I love the way you move it like that. Way you move your body, it's like you know. Got me going cuckoo like that. Yeah, I was thinking you and your friends. Sing a song and yes, I'm my vibes. Can we turn choking up on blunt? Yes, I'm my vibes. I'm my love. Yeah, I'm cuffing somebody tonight. Yeah, yes, I'm my love.
Baby, we're still out here on the beat down. You know what it is, the biggest, the dopest, the freshest, the sickest, the illest. And right about now, I have one of the biggest artists in the country, probably even Africa. It's the one and only Mr. Matebula. It's Sense in the building. How you doing, man?
I'm good, man. Yourself?
Fantastic. Cool. I would be a remiss if I didn't start by congratulating you on your recent step.
I'd like to congratulate you as well.
Kalabu, congratulations. Thank you, my man. How are you doing?
I'm all well, man. Yourself?
I'm fantastic, bro. I'm fantastic. Yeah. We're living and we're thriving. I mean, we're surviving through this tough time.
Yeah.
How's this period been for you? I know we all expected it to be 22 days.
It's been quite interesting for me. I think it has helped me have time to actually release an album.
Oh, yes.
And, you know, write an album, a full album, and release it, titled Rhythm of Silence.
Yeah.
And it has also made me get time to do my own projects, you know. As an artist, you get quite busy, you travel a lot, you never have time to yourself. So I just had time with my family. I even got married, you know.
Yeah.
So I quite enjoyed the time, but I think I'm not liking it anymore.
Now you've had enough time.
I think now it's time for making money.
It's time to go
we
back.
We can't be closing out.
Yeah, no, yeah. But at least we're opening up a bit by bit. Obviously, we're adapting a whole lot of things. We'll get to the adaptations. But let's real quick talk to Rhythm of Sands. How are you feeling? It's out there. Your baby is out there. The second one now. How's the response from everybody?
It's been great. We've already sold like 500 copies.
Nice.
Locally. Because music shops are closing, we had to clinch a deal with Pick and Pay.
Okay.
So right now the album is available in all Pick and Pay stores.
Nice.
Everywhere in Swaziland. Get it. So I'd say at the same time we're still getting used to the new normal, which is digital. And I think personally that's where most of the money comes from, because there are no costs. So digitally it's been responding quite well. We've had a great response. At some point we're in the top 100 in the iTunes charts. You know, so I think it's doing good. I hope it does better.
That's what's up. We're still out here on the beat down with your boy. And of course, as I said earlier, when I was with the communications manager from FNB, we were talking about Africa Day on Tuesday. And like we said, one of the artists being chosen to be part of it is the man I'm speaking to right now, Sands. Sands, before we get to Tuesday, obviously you're not someone who is new to the space of streaming your performances. How different is it for you? We saw, I think the first time I saw it was last year for the online bushfire
thing. Yeah.
And that performance was so good, you even got a nomination for it. So people were moved even from home. But how was it for you as an artist?
It was quite interesting, you know. Well, it was the first time I did such a thing. I can't wait for the FNB Africa Day next week, you know. I think it's just the new normal, you know. I've never gotten used to actually performing where I can't see the people I'm performing for. But for some reason, artists are people who are able to have imaginary friends, you know. So that's what is happening now. So it's something that I'm looking forward to and growing into that, you know. And I hope I'll do justice in this one.
Nice. As someone who is very loud and very proud of his buve bakhe, you know, what does Africa Day mean for you?
You know, firstly, I acknowledge the fact that Africa is the heart of the world. And as an African, I'm proud to be one of the tribes in Africa, which is Swati. You know, so Africa Day to me just means celebrating who I am. It's something that I'd love to do every day. It's who we are. Mm. Let's celebrate that. Let's put that out in the whole world. Let people know that we are proud of being ourselves. We're singing in our own language. We are dressing in our own way. We are doing things our own cultural way. It's never wrong.
So what are you hoping people are getting from this performance on Tuesday, Africa Day? Sands is being part of it. What are you hoping to bring to people? You know, because obviously as an artist you always have a message, but you also want to leave someone a certain feeling when they watch. So this is a big day, big performance.
I'm bringing Africa back to Africa, wherever it is.
Yeah.
You know, but mostly I'm performing new songs. I can't wait for people to listen to them, Egoli.
Yeah.
And all the like. So what I'm bringing is just the fun of being who we are, and in all ways enjoyable. And I hope people enjoy it, and I hope people buy my music.
There we go. It's too accessible now. It's out there at Pick and Pay. People can get it.
Yeah, you can get it everywhere, in all digital platforms and in all Pick and Pay stores.
What are you hoping for the future, man? We're just in the middle of 2021. What are you hoping to have achieved or have seen the world or the country achieve by December?
I'd love that the country achieves acknowledging music and artists to the fullest level. And I'd love us to all have money in this country.
Amen to that. Amen to that. Yeah. Sandiso Matsebula, aka Sands, ladies and gentlemen. I remember you can catch him live for free on Tuesday, courtesy of FNB. Check out the FNB Namibia page on their YouTube and also on their Facebook, and you can catch Sands, Olemseni, other artists from different parts of Africa. It's Africa Day. Be proud of being African. I wake up every day and I'm like, thank you, Lord. I live here in the cradle of life. It's the Beatdown. We'll be back after this.
Fallen soldiers that we left behind. Real niggas dying, fake niggas multiplying. Grown men crying, the world losing Kobe Bryant. Hell, I need to get up off my chest. Your favorite rapper nice, but he know K-Daro's the best. Went from selling dope, had my mama hella stressed. Now I'm selling dope records, boy, I did it just to flex. Main chick, driving me crazy. Side chick, tryna tell me that we're having a baby. Old homies tryna find me, hit my phone on a daily. I ain't answer, cut him off, cause the boy's full gazes. It's crazy, huh? Newsflash, I'm not friends with you niggas. I'm not tryna have lunch or break bread with you niggas. I'm doing me and progressing. I'm ahead of you niggas. I swear that life been sweeter since I dated you niggas. Okay, what's the cost to be the boss? It's pricey. Ironic how when niggas bitter, they start extra spicy. Rappers tryna battle, but their skills are kinda dicey. Sketchy with the pen and paid, I'll chalk him up precisely. It don't make you a real nigga cause you icy. You can turn a daughter off the streets into a wifey. Even if you copy all my moves, you nothing like me. I'm from a different cloth, you Mr. Price and I'm Versace. This comparison's getting a bit redundant. Let's just keep it 100 and stop with all of the frantic. Daryl's in the discussion, the hardest nigga who buzzing. I'm popping all of a sudden, your favorite's running and ducking. Ah, everyone got opinions just like Joe Budden. Probably knock on the fact that a nigga made it from nothing. Purchased my first equipment with money I made from hustling. Now I'm killing these vocals like Miss Jennifer Hudson. She's just sliding to the DMs like Adonis is dead. You niggas better hide your BMs like Adonis is dead. And when that chove comes to push, I'm strapped down to the T like that boy who laid it rain on Adonis is dead. All you niggas got opinions, but you lacking the facts. You stay capping like Make America Great Again hats. You ain't living what you rap, you just cap when you rap. You rap capping, you better off just shaking your ass. I write reality raps, you never could survive. I'm grateful that I made it out my daddy's house alive. Days without no food, a lot of shit I was deprived. By my evil stepmother Cinderella with the vibes. Back in high school they used to say that I'm a stoner. Now with social distancing I'm somewhat off a loner. Getting a job, Nipsey told me be the owner. Now we talk that same shit like COVID and Corona. Pen game sicker than the global pandemic. Wordplay smarter than a f***ing academic. I could have been a scrub, but I chose to level up. Niggas used to show me love until that money doubled up. Ironic how your biggest fan can be your biggest hater. The shooters turn to Judas, even Jesus had a trader in his crew. When it's time to meet the woo, all we do is drop dope. I'm Mary Jean, Billie Jean, R.I.P. to Pop Smoke.
Yeah, man, we're out there on the beatdown. You know what it is, your boy. Now, a lot of people ask me, how do I get on the show? A lot of people are trying to get on the show. First things first, you ain't got to have my number. You ain't got to see me. You ain't got to talk to me. All you got to do is show us the work, okay? So if you're an artist and you'd like an interview on the beatdown, just send through your demo on email or drop it off at Eswatini TV. The email is l48@gmail.com. Just send through your video or send through your... like I said, demo, you know, one or two songs, and then make sure you say who you are, and of course, what the music is, and how we can get a hold of you. Because a lot of people just send songs, you know, you just get drummerboy69@gmail.com, track one, and you're like, what is this, my guy? We need to be able to call you to invite you to do the show. If you have a music video that you'd like to get played on the show, just email it, l48@gmail.com. That's ELFOE8@gmail.com. That is the email to send. You do not have to meet me anywhere. Must I please, must I please be like, please let me say this one more time. You ain't got to tell nobody. You ain't got to meet up with nobody. Just send it through. And if, you know, you meet the standards, we call you up. It's that simple. It's that easy, okay? That's all it is. That's all it is. Anyway, let's move on with the music. Let's check this one out.
Ayo, hey, Nevs, I see you, bro.
Nevs on the track, nigga.
Been a while. Guess who's back? I took a break. I came back. Shit is still the same. Niggas still sleeping. Still debating. Who's hot? Who's not? I ain't worried about no competition. Walking blindfolded. Send no competition. The opposition. Elevation. Mindset shifted to a different vision. Confirmation and no validation. I was 16. Shook the entire nation with the 16s. I done made a name. Power invested in me. I wanna take every kid out the streets. I wanna see them in Ghana degrees. We need more doctors, more teachers, more lawyers. We need the doctors to heal us, more teachers to teach us. The lawyers protect us, the system is cool. I remember what happened to B-Da. He was gunned down in a cold case. Justice was never served, just another victim of unsolved cases. Lalanga Tulaga Socha would see you in heaven. The battle continues as long as we're here. We've been fighting the fight like the statue of liberty, holding the light all through the night, fighting for peace. Most of the youth unemployed, I'm even filling the void. Most of our dreams got destroyed. Wish all the stories were told. We gonna try to avoid. How are those kids really killing the net? Why they ain't playing on radio? They even claim with their audios. The people are feeling it, people are vibing. We're talking to clubs, people were grooving. We're talking to church, people were praising. The body we're raising, we're never relaxing. Yeah. Never relaxing, never relaxing. Yeah, cooling and jala benzima mascala bascella siasala sa pusha sa panda sa tula sa palagualunga basala ya nyuga ne praza ba kurgus patiala. Bas checka bas pega bas pite manika sa tula sa buga ne timbo ta chinga sa kutang and follow sa mega tacha glonga tu. Sa shabela botane cool, wa chabli matoti ne timbo ta kanya wa fulegi mnyango wa sonda ba sonding. I'm shying a satang and coming in goati. I got the juice on you, my 2040. How you a rapper, boy, you turn a 40. Man, that she's salty, and your whole team.
Yeah, like it's been a while. I've been at the scene for a while. You know, it's all about trying to get all the energies that we need to try and make the music that you guys are looking for and that you guys vibe for. You know what it is.
Yo, unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of the show. Thank you so much for tuning in. A big shout out to FNB for coming through. A big shout out to Sands for coming through. And an enormous shout out to you for watching from wherever you have been. We appreciate you so much. Hit us up on Facebook and on Twitter. On Facebook, it's The Beatdown. On Twitter, it's at The Beatdown TV. If you're looking for me personally, it's at I am Elfo on Instagram and on Twitter. And Elfo on Facebook. Elfo is spelled E-L-F-O-E. Guys, next week, same time, same place, I'll be here. Otherwise, have a beautiful weekend. Stay safe, please. Keep your mask on. Keep your physical distancing on. And of course, wash your hands and sanitize all the time. We can't beat this COVID thing together, okay? Otherwise, remember, Jesus is King. God loves you. I love you. Peace.